Ladies and gentlemen, one of these teams will be going home. FaZe Clan versus Optic. Let's make some noise. First map of the best of three. There it is. A bit of noise there. As we get into this one, it's going to be 5 sets of armor for Optic on the CT side here. FaZe Clan have got a single smoke and 2 Molotovs. That's an interesting buy. It's pretty unorthodox. Normally you have 1 for this map, but obviously the Molotov very strong on train for that post-plant situation, especially if you're going towards inside, where it looks like that's where FaZe will be ending up as they start to assemble in the brown halls here.
The interesting aspect again of this factory is okay, they're playing far back inside B. Good headshot from Stan to find the first one at range, but it's a Glock return. And he's taken down immediately, traded out. That's going to let the bomb go in, but Keo's taking the bomb quite far up the sidewalk. Has to turn back to go to default. Really, Mitt lost track of the fact that he has it. The problem is he's losing his teammates in the time that he realizes and gets back in place. And he's got to stay on top of the train as well. They're already pushing onto him. He's gone. No angle to play. Push from both sides. Kerrigan 1v4 to try and hold this off. Molotov's going to bounce very early as well. So despite no kits, that will be extinguished, and there should still be plenty of time to get this defused.
Yeah, absolutely. That's why most teams tend to go towards that inside area. Oh, be careful, Tarek. That's why most teams normally go towards this inside area. You almost guarantee the bomb, regardless of the round outcome. Obviously, FaZe got mowed down there. It's an easy victory for Optic there. But they get the bomb down, and he's going forward on the T side. He gets the AKs in the third round. I would say something's behind the second, but they haven't really got enough kills to justify that. You need to be getting 3 or 4 kills so you can get the AKs out. So you can almost assume it's going to be AKs on the third. This will be one of those redundant rounds, trying to get the bomb down as early as possible. And this one, if it's possible, amazing. They're going to have such a strong buy. It could happen if they go towards inside again, just rush down low ramp with one of those P250s, they get a lucky trade. Bomb might be planted, but that's going to be the only objective of this round now.
And just to note with that Molotov too, when there's no kits, it's so powerful. But firstly, they didn't identify there wasn't any kits. And secondly, thrown early. If you had found one kill by chance and then thrown it, maybe there's something in it.
Yeah, even in a 4-1.
Interesting, exactly how powerful that really is when there's no kits in play. But Stan going to already be facing off toward the B side, spots up. It's Kiyoshima that's crossed over, throws a nade his direction, but as you say, Redundant Round, they're just trying to get information if they could get a second bomb plant out of this. Huge.
That would be tremendous. It's very unlikely, but if they do manage to bring it together, that's a nice headshot. Tarek going down to 22 HP, two of the hands of Rain, but he will be dropped by Mixwell. It'll be a 5-on-4 now in favor of Optic. They're just trying to keep rifles up at this point. They know the AKs are coming out in the third. Try and keep these 4 rifles in their hands. They've got Stanislaw on the MP9, trying to farm some cash here, try and throw him into the choke points and see what he can do here. But no one has to commit, no one has to do anything. Just hold back, stop the bomb going down. That's the only objective for Optic, really, as well. Take it easy, try and save the utility, and just try and keep 5 players on.
Mixwell the next to try and make contact down toward A main. Still, they put pressure on this direction. We talk about how often it is that teams will go to B in these situations when they need the fast plant. This time, still putting pressure onto A and bomb as well. Get down toward the bottom of Pop Dog's gonna rotate back up. This is interesting because Stan's already bypassed this. Kerrigan, not even gonna look and realize that. His teammates are gonna walk into it. They'll go down. Does that give away that the bomb's bypassed though? Because they could still get a plant out of this. And Kerrigan realizes it. He's gone. He knows that they've bypassed. He knows that they're in the halls. So they will get a second plant. Huge for utility in the next round.
Yeah, regardless of the round outcome, that's amazing for them. They're not gonna win this round. Absolutely not. But that's so huge. The blunder, I have to say, from Optic. They do get the final kills. It's a comfortable round, sure, but there's going to be a ton of money going forward for FaZe Clan. They're going to be very happy that round. Nothing really invested into it. 2 P250s, no nades. This is a round where Optic have to hold on. The good news is, though, they keep 4 rifles alive. They'll have all the grenades they need, defuse kit. They'll probably upgrade the MP9 as well. I'm not 100% sure they'll do that. He's got 6K. Knowing the AKs are coming, I'd say that's probably the wise move to do, but here we go then, the first, I guess you can call it gun run at this point, considering the amount of money FaZe has available to them. They go for 5 AK-47s.
I like that sign. That's my favorite sign I've seen all year.
Stop dabbing.
That's my favorite sign.
Don't even say that word. Everyone will start doing it. It's not going to work. You just have to embrace it, Matt.
I think I want to sign that sign.
Sign the sign.
I'll give it my approval.
Oh, here we go. All the utility for FaZe. Smokes, Molotovs, and looks like they may be focusing towards it. Carrigan going quite quickly to take advantage of the brown halls. CT's looking to get aggressive, though. This MP9 will be rushed to kick things off, though, taking out Ray.
Pick up fine, but it's immediately FaZe that respond. Rush wow. Gets 2 very quickly. In fact, the same 2 that found kills on the way through. So this changes tremendously already as they've committed to this site. Keo catching Rush in the middle, though, does open up a chance for the bomb to slip back through as Keo already at the hitch. Smoke off towards Z as well. Will limit rotations, but little do they know they're not going that direction. They're going to hold up. Mix is going to wait at the bottom of the ladder right now, Pop Dog, because Stan's going into A main, and AZ, he's anticipating they're rotating through CT. He could be left in the open here.
It's actually a massive advantage overall for FaZe. You can see Stanislaw only on that MP9, hasn't been able to upgrade yet. Great post-plant situations, very difficult side to retake.
And again, AZ now sees the nade coming in, just looking the wrong direction. That gives away his position to slip in from underneath, gets spotted up, and Stan goes for the ladder rather than going down the lane. It's going to catch him out because he can't set his aim fast enough. Fixwell's got to get aggressive, and FaZe will pick up round 3.
They do indeed. There are some FaZe fans in the house, it seems. And his phase clan there with a nice aggressive play towards outside. You can see Rush locking them down. He gets three kills overall, but that's all they really get, Optic. And they go into round number four. We'll see what there is available for Optic. Should have money overall. They've got an AWP in the hands of Mixwell, a Famous, two M4s, and Tarek yet to buy. He's got $3,600. He's just working out what his approach is going to be. We do have a pause coming in. This is going to be technical at this stage, or tactical, some would say.
Tactical, yes. Yep. That's your coined word, yep. A redundant word at this point in time. It's like coming up with a new name for the sewing machine. I guess the sewing machine you still use. Maybe for like a typewriter.
Yeah, that's true.
That's more accurate.
Well then, so there will be a buy for Optic, but a nice start there for FaZe after getting bombed down in the pistol and the eco as well. They managed to get themselves in a strong position here. It came down to a 2-on-2 in the end, but they managed to keep those last two players alive. So money's on an amazing situation. There's quite a lot of reset potential for both teams here. Whoever loses this round is pretty much guaranteed to be on eco. So we have got four players from the CDs heading towards outside. Stanislaw by himself. To be fair, he is very good at the inside position. He's actually one of the players that's impressed me a lot in that particular area. Tarek looking to get a little bit aggressive here. Just slipping in towards Popdog. And we have got some Ivy control coming from FaZe as well. They've got the advantage, they've got the M4s, but Mixwell on the AWP could be a bit of a nuisance for them.
Kerrigan trying to get down. He's going to get peeked out here. Naf not around the corner just yet. Caught with the nade, potentially. Doesn't peek fast enough, though. Kerrigan smokes out two play, and they're both going to go down. That should open up ladder, but look at Tarek. Keo's going to come in late. He's already found one at the front of the site. Thankfully, AZ still able to pick up Rush because it was turned back quite quickly. Still, though, it's only a one-man advantage. And Mix with a smart nade knows AZ's coming in from long. Nearly takes him down. 6 HP. And a smart boost to get back over top of the smoke, but a safe plant coming in from Alu should leave a decent post plant. AZ's not going to get aggressive, though he can't afford to. And it's all Keo to find the information versus the two remaining players, and Mixwell, even smarter, knows that still this is where AZ resides, and he's going to push back through CT spawn to try and get toward old bomb. Kiyoshima with good elevation, good vision, but still has to just wait for them to walk back out. Spots on the shoulder, Mixwell's going to get information on that, has to change his angle, change his location. Again, his teammate AZ can't play much off of this. He's waiting for information based on Keo's calls. And then play the perfect position on the bomb. Smokes out. Does he know where it's planted? Does he have it lined up? Certainly does. Keo's got one already. And it's down to just Stanislaw remaining. No kit round over.
Yeah, almost an impossible situation that 2-on-2. Yes, it's equal in terms of manpower, but they don't have the grenades to work with. They've got no position on the outside bomb side. No kits there. The smoke on the bomb. A 10-second defuse coming in. It's a desperate last attempt. Doesn't really work out for them. And as I said, Optic now will be onto a pretty much full eco here. They've got around $2,000 per player. Could force into it. But I doubt they will at this point. It's going to be round number five. FaZe Clan is running a nice little default there. AZ, very strong individual talent there for FaZe Clan, managing to get those decent trade frags towards Ivy. And the bomb goes down with the retake, not successful for Optic. So at this point, you can see FaZe, they're reading the economy quite nicely. I think most players can work out this situation. It's not exactly rocket science at this point. So there's going to be SMGs across the board, really. Two MAC-10s, Rain with the UMP as well, just trying to farm that cash, keep things nice and close range. That does suggest they'll go towards inner. You get that bomb down, you can push down the tracks there and try and find a kill. Kerrigan is going to be selling something towards Ivy. Get one kill here, that's pretty much round over. He's just trying to keep all the five-man stack from Optic Gaming on the outside bomb side.
And double smoke off, he's able to do so successfully thus far.
Well, CT spawn as well, this is quite a dinner from him.
Cleared it, information gained all that's required. He can hold off the rotations as well.
Yeah, perfect.
And they know he has an SMG. With three SMGs in play,
to be fair,
how much exit frag money do they want to give away?
This is the thing, because Optic have got default pistols across the board, right? Okay, well, that's a good start. That works. The P2000 outgunning the MAC-10 there. Alu comes in, swiftly returns the favor, but Optic are actually doing a pretty decent job here. We said there'll be an opportunity to farm cash here, and now Rain will be cashing in. He gets two kills, $1,200 in the bank. 3-on-2, and Tarek and Rush remain. But to be fair, considering the situation, the bomb going down that early, they did pretty well to even get a couple of kills there. Have a look at the money for them going into the next round. They've got third stage loss bonus after this one, so $2,400 coming in. So yeah, a decent buy. I think they can just about squeeze out an AWP. But it would be a glass cannon at this point. So there it is. FaZe Clan do take the lead 3-2 after losing the pistol. Yeah, there is an AWP available in the hands of Stanislaw, but $4,900, it would be a full glass cannon for him. I'm not sure that's the right call. I'd probably want to go for five rifles at this
point. They've already gone for it. He's already bought an M4.
Yeah, well, there you go. At a great position now. Now Alu has the AWP. The guys on the desk mentioned it. He's going to be the pivotal factor here for FaZe. If you start working those picks, he's very good at that for FaZe. That's why he was brought in to be the dedicated AWPer. He's been playing very well for them recently, I have to say. So I'm impressed with the addition of Alu. Let's see what he can do here. We can find some opening picks as we go into round number six against the five rifles here. No kits once again for Optic.
And sets for the fast play to try and get toward Hitch early. He's actually waiting for anyone to get on train and go aggressive on the CT side. Guardian likes to play the same angle but fire through the wall to catch anyone at Z. He didn't quite have the same spawn to get there in time to do so. And Rush, meanwhile, is going to smoke this off. So whether or not Alu sits, okay, that's good enough. Changes elevation. Or does he rotate back down toward the alley position instead? This is the call they have to make because AZ's still waiting down there alone, and Kerrigan's holding up to get information in the first pick with Bomb.
Yeah, let's remember as well, the last time these guys played at E-League, the actual final score on this map was 16-3 in favor of Optic. So FaZe have already bested their last total, so they're doing well so far. This is a very important round. This could actually force Optic to another eco as well. And you can see the SMG in the hands of Kerrigan. That becomes interesting with three players without Headhunter, even four, sorry. So the UMP is actually very viable in this situation. The bomb heading towards inside, it seems. Maybe a couple of smokes towards outer. Try and send a couple of players to find some kills there, force rotations before the teammates get ready to go in.
Could still actually go back to outer as well if they cause rotations, because Kerrigan's in the middle of this 2-2 split basically on either side with bomb.
They're going to explore outside. If they find kills there and find they've actually got control of the outer bomb site, then they can bring the bomb back, right? But if they find 1-2 kills, it's a trade, then they go towards inner.
Kerrigan's staying above the ladder. He's heading down the stairs now toward inner, so they are causing chaos, causing commotion, finding the kill and stand. That'll confirm it. Mix is the next in line to rotate over. He's outside of the Z connector now, but Molotov there is going to leave his teammate Tarek inside of it. So the next rotation comes from Nafly at CT spawn. Alu's already staring down that lane for an entry point. No kits for Optic. You already mentioned money's tight, having not won the last round.
It'll
be four in a row. Exactly that. I'd get out right now. Yep. Don't even face. Let four stay alive.
No kits, no nades. Save those weaponry. You're not going to win this round. It's 100% done. So you can see AZ. He was a player outside, actually waiting for these rotations. Now, if he can find kills, everyone he finds is very important to the economy of Optic as well. He takes down Tarek. Five players still alive, but as I say that, AZ does go down. Rush finds him there with the M4A1S. And these last three remaining CTs do need to stay alive at this point if they want to have a chance of buying it the next round. So pretty much perfect execution there from FaZe. As we said, two players with the smokes outside, taking the attention away from inner. As soon as the smokes go over, they're going chasing towards the inner side, finding that first kill. Bomb goes down, round over.
Interestingly enough, from Rush, when he took that fight against AZ, he didn't have to. He could have easily ran that toward Ivy. If he had gone down there, obviously he wins it, so no harm, no foul. But if he had gone down there and they lose his second rifle, then they can't even buy in the utility to force up and the second rifle now. So to force this up into a situation where they have any advantage at all.
Well,
so a bit of risk in even just taking that fight from far.
It's going to be round number seven here. They do have the three weapons saved. They can buy around this. It's not ideal by any stretch of the imagination. Stannis on the Famous. Do have a couple of kits to Simon, a few more nades in the previous round, but still going to be a struggle. Eco still looming. This is a great position for Tarek. Going for the double kill here. Actually doesn't commit and only gets one, but that's still fine. He's still alive. As I say that though, Keo does take down Rush and equalizes the situation. 4-4 now, and Rain looking to find something here for main entrance.
Push up from Tarek. Next one with a shot under Rain gives him a chance to hold this position. Alu tries to get desperately inside of the A main position, but can't get an angle. He's locked himself in behind the box. Has a smoke to his left. That'll protect him from anyone walking down Pop Dog. And right now, there's a huge shooter that wants that position, but missed shots. No hit from Alu. Gets in behind the E-box. Tarek's still going to be alive in this. They have to give him so much attention. They've already got B covered off. Stan's pushed to the corner. Tarek's still menacing them. As it's just Alu. Good up close shot, but maybe it's too little, too late, because Mixwell's already on top of him. Sprays him down through the wall.
Wow.
And that works out. I tried to go back, actually, because I was talking about Rush taking that fight. He bought into zero, and I think the kill actually did allow him to bring out that extra FAMAS.
Well, there it is.
So perhaps it was worth it in the end. I didn't quite catch if he bought it or not.
Alu there, when he came out main entrance, he saw a player by Poco. I don't think he could believe his luck. He thought, wow, this is a kill on the plate. Doesn't nail the shot there and actually opens up the door for Optic to get back into this round. It was Tarek going aggressive in towards Pop Dog. They were up against in terms of the buy. Needed to make something happen. He finds that first kill. Definitely had two available, but made the safe bet there, fell back, and he brings Optic round number three. Optic now do have the AWP in the hands of Mixwell, someone who said he was falling back from that primary AWP role, but to be fair, he has been very good at it, especially at this event. And we go for a fastest queue here. Rush opening things up. AZ responds quickly though. It's going to be a bloodbath here on the outer bomb side.
Very fast indeed from FaZe. Nafly finds one at McKerrigan. Bomb's still not planted. They've got this back to just a one-man deficit. They can still work with this. Keo's going to try and lock off the most obvious rotation point, but both of them working in tandem right now. Stanislaw and Nafly. Canadians of the Optic side. One of them's lost his head already. Keo with a great shot. Knows he's at the hitch right now. And Stan's going to get to him before a trade or position for a crossfire can be established. So he's brought this into a situation where he can still work with it. Has a kit. 73 HP. Molotov as well, but no smoke to put on top of the bomb, so he's therefore got to go for fights, and he's got to go quickly if he's going to make this work.
Very quickly indeed. I don't think there's much chance here. Drops the incendiary. Needs to find two kills still. This is over. It's a pretty desperate situation for him now. Alu punishes him there at the end. Not really much he can do, to be fair. You normally want to have your best clutch players playing the inside position like standards, because those kind of situations, the bomb's down 2-on-1. He wants to see what he can do there, but unfortunately that was a stretch too far, And we're going to go into round number 9. I think the money finally has been taken down. This is interesting then, Matt. Optic do actually purchase an AWP. Stannistor had almost $5,000. Teammates could be on pistols. He buys the orb. This is a big call to make. So,
interestingly, it levels his money back to everyone else.
True.
But you're right. It could be a utility or a gun dropped over in a future round.
Don't get me wrong. These rounds can work out. He just needs to be dynamic. He needs to be hunting for frags. He gets one, repositions, maybe goes back towards inner. It can be effective, but it's certainly a high-risk situation. There we go. Gets the first kill. He wants to reposition now. He is baiting in now.
Exactly. That's exactly what he's trying to do at this point in time. Naf's there with a deagle. He wants to get him in position. Stands down, though. Op gone. No one gets to rotate over that direction. Rush could try and do so, but he's pinched in at hell because he doesn't know what's going on out toward A main. So Naf instead takes the fight, finds the AK that was down in that position, and Mixwell does make his way to get that AWP and move back in towards the connector. So they still have two guns to work with in this. However, look at the information they're gathering. Yeah. Naf's pushing so far up outer. Rush knows they're not inside. They're going to rotate early on this, and they're actually going to be in the right positions.
See, they got the orb coming in towards the inner side as well. This could be interesting now. FaZe Clan are going to presumably fully execute the site. Smoke down lower ramp, maybe smoke on the bomb side as well. Molotovs will go in, flashes. But if Mixwell can find one, maybe two kills, with Naf coming in the back at this sort of time as well, this could actually be problematic for FaZe.
Rush is there now as well, rotated back through CT. Mix is waiting. He wants that opening in the lane, and they're going to get the pistol players get a little bit closer. Rush is already involved train himself. Mix finds it. It's the one-man advantage. Finds another potentially. Can't land the shot, but Tarek's got one of the 5-7. And the buy might work out unless Alu finds something more. He's got to go to an AK. Close play with Rush. Knows he's below. Doesn't want to overcommit to the peak because that would leave him exposed to the greed. But Naf wide and then lands it. A great bait and switch play out toward Long wins them the round.
One AWP and four pistols. That's all it takes, apparently. We said it can work for them. It's definitely a high-risk maneuver, but to get that first pick, Mixel picks up the AWP. And what a play from Naf, pushing towards the Ivy. Someone had to get information there, and he gets a bunch of it. Pushing all the way towards the T-Halls as well. He actually locks him in towards the inner side. Mixel already there with the AWP. Nails that first shot, and this makes it very problematic for FaZe. They can't really get anything done there. Very big round for Optic to win. I think that has actually put FaZe in an eco situation as well. This is a fantastic opportunity for Optic to actually take the lead of this point and tie things up this round at 5-5. This is a timeout. I'm not sure if it's technical or tactical. Do we know?
I didn't see the call come in and I can't get into
tactical pause. We don't there get we that. I have to look behind
it's
us.
True. We get the direct feed. I didn't see it come out in chat, so I missed that. Interestingly enough, the buy goes the other way now. It's going to be a single op. And a little bit better than just the op and pistols because they've got an AK out on the T side as well. It's Tech 9 for Kerrigan.
Well then, Alu.
Glass cannon as well.
Yeah,
the
pressure's on him. We did say he's great. It's one of his best skills, opening on the map for his team, finding those initial frags, and we'll see whether he can do it this time. Now, needed more than ever. He'll be heading towards inside. A lot of AWPers will go to his upper ramp to try and lock it down of one player. This time, though, it's going to be Stannistor. He's only got the UMP, so if they were to go in, this is the most opportune moment to do it, but you can see Mixwell now in the connector. He'll be backing him up.
Stan's backed away from trying to get information above that smoke. Rain had a position advantage on him by getting the crosshair placement with the deagle already placed before the opportunity presented, so smart read from Stan to back away. Quick smoke, short smoke to drop inside of the site, no vision gain from far. That therefore limits Mixwell's potential to try and cover off the upper position. Stan's on top of the drain, they haven't spotted him. Somehow he slips back down. Mixwell saves him by taking out Rain behind. But he does get taken out in the end by AZ, that one AK-47. 18 HP left on him. Keo pushing forward. The problem is they've got the ball on the top of the default. They've got to get toward that and get it down if they want any chance of trying to take advantage of the situation with guns. Good shot from AZ, but it's still only 19 HP on him, and now only him remaining with that. Bomb gets dropped as well. Sat in the open. Good flanking from Tarek.
Well, no bomb going down, and three players surviving for Optic. It was a desperate bribe for FaZe, and they do get towards the inner side, but Alu can't get anything done with that AWP whatsoever. They go down to 2K now. It has to be an eco at this point. 5-5. Optic tie things up. After winning the pistol and the force spy on the third from FaZe Clan, they got themselves in a decent position here, but still, to be fair, like we said, 16-3 in their last showing on this map against Optic. They're doing well so far. Still, plenty of rounds to go. Five on the T side is definitely workable. Even if they just stay to five, there's still a chance to actually win the game. So anything else at this point is a bonus. I'd say they've done the hard work already.
Rain beats the Molotov in position toward him in. Alu's going with the bomb again. They look, despite Rain's position, and AZ out toward Ivy, who's just trying to get the position and get a reader. Nice. Looking again to bring that bomb to upper, but Stan's going to cut off Keo. Might not get the plant after all, even though they're heading toward that side of the map.
Well. Full eco, really. FaZe, very limited with their options, it has to be said. Going towards inner, it seems one player faking towards outside of Rain.
To be fair, Stan's the only one still on B, and he just has the UMP, so if they catch him off
it's
with
good
an
day,
angle...
right? He's just going to farm cash. They're not going to be able to kill him with Glocks.
Just the bomb going down, though, if they can get that in, just to keep in mind. They're going to be able to buy in the next round either way, but Stan's going to be there and perfectly set. As you mentioned, he's going to take it down. Cash is fine for them. But it does limit them slightly because they can't go for a full op buy without that bomb plant.
Indeed, that would have been amazing. See, Ali on $4,400 right now, he cannot buy the orb. And there's a double orb set up for Optic now. It can be very deadly on trade. Naf and Mixwell will be controlling either side of the map here. And we have got 5 acres of phase. In terms of the utility as well, not the best buy. They have got the smokes, but only one Molotov and a few flashbangs. Going to be difficult for them. Probably going to be some sort of execution. Their default was actually very effective last round. They were actually focusing towards Ivy. That's a round I was actually impressed with. And Naf, he's taking the orb towards Inner. That's actually one of the strongest places you can set up. If you get that orb set up on the upper platform like he is doing right now, you can actually have four players towards outside.
And gets there late as well. You normally see that be a positional, spawn positional, but exactly, they can rotate away. He's already got the information, finds the first shot. As soon as he gets that, back comes Stanislaw over toward the site.
So he now can rotate. He doesn't need to stay towards Inner. He's shown his presence there. He's probably funneled them towards outside. He can probably leave Stanislaw inside by himself. Yeah, so Naf moves away. This is perfect. It's really textbook CS at the moment.
And Stan's going to push up and get aggressive once more, still on that UMP. So he wants the angle advantage, Tarek. He can play control. They've got smokes potentially still to go to outer, but it's going to be Stan winning out Keo. This will be outer now. They have to go to ward A. They've lost everything they had at B, and good positioning, as you mentioned, on these rotations is going to cover that off early.
It's good rotations, good adaptions, and it's reading the game very well. Alu does find a frag with that AK-47. There's still a lot of work to do here.
Big positional kill, though, because now they have all of Hell and Sandwich to work with. Mixwell's limited off. They can still get a ball plant out of this. All they need is Azian Rain to stay alive and hold the angles, but that's already been taken apart. Tarek finds the opening kill. And Rain has it all to do to create space. Gone again to Nafly. Alu, he may have the bomb at 34 HP. This round's going to Optic. So 7-5 is where we'll sit going into round 13. Tarek's going to be the one to close it out.
Yeah, like I said, textbook is definitely an operative word there. We're describing that round for Optic game. And the orb going towards the upper platform. We haven't seen that yet. It's a nice little surprise for FaZe as they come towards those Brown Horde area. Gets that first pick. And as I said, you rotate that player off. Because then at that point, FaZe are adjusting for an orb at that point. Stanislaw actually has the balls to push up lower ramp, and that's a really strong move. He's got an SMG, a close-range weapon. They might have nades in their hand, might be adjusting for an execution towards the inner site. He finds one kill. They wouldn't be expecting that. It's just really nice to watch at the moment. It's going to be 7-5 in favor of Optic. Another eco for FaZe. They have got Deagles, PD-50s, and a flashbang. I would say go towards inner, flash over the little window you have at the top there, and try and get the bomb down. It's going to be the best bet. That's there. Once again, though, nails that orb shot, and Tarek chimes in as well.
Hasn't even had time to rotate. He gets there so quickly. They're already committing to outer as a result, and they're already all down, all five staying up. Money for the rest of the half on the Optic side. Well into the 5K range for two players, 9K for Mixwell, excuse me, and very little to work with after this buy on the FaZe side. It's a full loss round bonus against them. Bomb plants will at least get them to force up in the next, so they'll be able to close out the half.
Well, here we go then. Round number 14, there is the orb for Alu again, but to be fair, he hasn't had a huge amount of input here so far. Round number 14, they have got the AWP, 4 AKs, smokes and Molotovs as well, so they can go for execution if required. We have seen that AWP from Naf a couple of times towards the inner site. I think this is the point, it's when you go towards outer. You show your presence there twice in a row, they'll be adjusting to it, they'll be wasting a lot of nade to try and push you back when you're not even there. So this would be quite nice, and yeah, Stanislaw in there by himself means the AWP's actually going to be towards outer this time. Nafbly will be playing towards Ivy, so he's completely changed his position on the map. This is what top AWPers will normally do.
Good flash, and yet Rush is able to dodge that. Looked like he was dead to rights, finds the shot, and Tarek's there to support with a cross from E-Box. Already two kills in their name. Naf's gonna rotate over the cover off Ivy passively, and Tarek again goes aggressive, finds Kerrigan. No bomb plant coming out of this round. At least not with any substantial changes. The only one that could potentially make something of this is Kiyoshima coming down late toward Hawkdog position, but Tarek and Rush have such a good board stance. Easy will grab bomb, get toward the inside of the site. They've just backed away enough to let him slip down the lane. Rush has to hit the shot. Shoulder shown. Secondary peek from Mixwell. Well played.
Well, there it is. An adaption once again from Optic, changing the setup completely. The AWP towards the Ivy position. M4's up close. It's winning those Angels time and time again. Optic swinging six rounds in a row now. And we go to round number 15. It's a little replay from Rush. Up close and personal. Backed up by Tarek as well. A nice fragging duo taking down FaZe there. Looks very comfortable as well. FaZe maybe running out of steam at this point. It's going to be round number 15. They've got 4 AKs, a Tech 9 in the hands of Alu after purchasing that AWP in the last round. Yes, they have maximum loss bonus, but he wants to have a bit of utility here. I would say a set piece is almost guaranteed if he's going for that sort of buy. Incendiary comes in, knocks out Rain from actually pushing aggressively the side of the round, and Tarek holding a little bit shallower this time towards the bomb site.
Watch Naf. Far back is his denial. There's run boost for Kerrigan to get across. He was known as a good secondary AWPer. Go back to December of 2014, he had some crazy good highlights on Mirage. They stepped up tremendously on the Optic side. Mixwell's going to be wielding the second one this time. Naf's going to have to give up a little bit of ground, though. Smoke's off both right and left, so rap potential's there, but Rush is going to come back in as the first one dissipates. And Tarek will cover off Sandwich, which will leave room down the lane to allow Rush to support. Now fly, good play from Tarek as well. Pushes forward, has ball, knows they're inside of the site, but he's giving up the space behind him. Not allowed Brain to wrap back in. Puts Rush in an awkward situation. You can see how both those members had the same obligation of covering off ground to cover each other.
Oh.
It still comes back and works out, though, because Nafly finds out that they are walking in late, and it's all onto Kiyoshima. Bomb down still at the lane, and all the way back toward A main.
He wasn't even looking towards either. That was a complete sick flick shot going on there. You could tell from his the angle his ult was actually facing. 10-5 for Optic, though. You could see the string of four rounds for FaZe. That's when they broke the economy in the third after getting the bomb down in the first couple of rounds there. They actually had a good grasp of the game at that point, but it fell apart towards the end. Optic started adjusting that double orb setup. FaZe has had no reply for it. And they're in a great position now going into the second half. But I did say, Matt, five rounds is enough. Anything up at that point was a bonus, right? So no bonus acquired, but it's enough to win this game.
Going to the previous history, as you already mentioned, too, though, 16-3 last time.
True.
So five rounds, short, traditionally speaking, is enough. There's opportunity there, but is it enough for FaZe Clan against Optic in this case? Start off the pistol round this time. We do have a kit, at least, on the CT side. It's going to be Kiyoshima. Complement that with a nade, but two smokes for Optic, which suggests they're not going for the outer play. In fact, it is going to be, rather, the inner play. So it is going to be the outer play. Good entrance from Mixwell. Takes down AZ. You like the first shot that he found, though, so it leaves it 4-on-4. Nade damage as well is going to do substantial on to Mixwell. Rush gone. Gets in. Now two men, though. They've got to hold this off. Alley wraps in quickly. They've got the kit. Remember to play this off. And flies the last alive. Finds one. Looks to his right. Can't respond fast enough for Kyo to slip through.
There was a moment there I was believing. And now for that first shot, I thought he could actually do something in that 3-1. But they get the bomb down. Kind of similar situation to FaZe in the first half. Don't win the round. It's quite convincing for FaZe Clan overall. Some great shots coming in there from Alley as well. Easy open things up towards main entrance. Smokes towards the connector between the bomb train and towards Ivy as well. It's designed just to get that plant down nice and early. It works, but it's going to be some great shots of those silent USPs from Alu, as you can see on your screen right now. Nice work from him. And FaZe win a much-needed pistol here as we go into round number two. And as I said before, same reasons Optic will be taking an eco this round. They get a couple of smokes. Same sort of attempt, though. Try and get the bomb down this round. It's not necessarily to win it. You get some PD-50s, a few smokes. They're trying to add to your total when you buy up those AKs in the third round.
So Kia's going to push as fast as he possibly can towards hauling out inner. But they're going to rush him equally with pistols, slowed by the smoke. Rain's gotten in underneath them as well, so they've actually got them pitched off quite quickly, considering that could have been an awkward situation for Kiyoshima to find himself in. No information attained toward A main or to Ivy, yet Alu's already rotated over to Z, so they've got the sound above them to know that this was going to be a hard push. And no flashes as well to drop down in that position in the ladder, so safe place for Rain to play.
Well, here we go. One smoke remaining at this point. So we have used one smoke towards the inner side on the lower ramp, right? So I'm not sure what they're planning to do with it. They haven't really taken them advantage at that point. Rain finds an easy kill towards Nafi, tries to go down Popdog blindly, doesn't get anything for it, just gets taken down. So, like we said, the bomb, that's going to be the main objective of this round for Optic, and it's not looking likely at this point. They still have that one smoke, and some PD-50s as well, but with two players watching the inside area, I guess the good news is Alu only has the silent USP, so he won't be able to necessarily mow them down, but his teammate, who's it going to be? It's Kiyoshima, certainly can.
Way through already. Alu's gone. Rush with the opening, but Kiyoshima's mentioned there still. Tarek, the next in line. He's bomb. He's going to try and get this planted immediately. And he's got the chance to do it, but Rain is on the case and just barely denies. Good body block from Stanislaw to try and take that and allow the damage to get slipped away. But FaZe bring themselves up to 7, winning the pistol again. The early buy in the last. They're giving themselves the exact chance he talked about. And already they're going to go on to the AWP.
Well, this is why Alu, that's why he had the silent USP in the previous rounds. Obviously, it's a little bit high risk. You can see he got punished for it. Couldn't find a kill though. Couldn't really back up Kiyoshima at that point, but he does get an AWP and he knows he's going against AKs this round. He has a huge advantage. The world is his oyster going to round number 18 here. He can choose any position and have the upper hand because he knows they don't have a sniper rifle after that second bomb did not get planted. So let's see what Alu gets up to here. I'm sure he's going to be the pivotal factor going into it, but we do have the AKs for Optic. Limited utility, two smokes to be exact, and Alu hunting for this first frag now.
Rain's playing toward the sandwich position to watch A-Main, but Kerrigan, meanwhile, with that UMP, still going to watch out toward Ivy. Will be utility, that's his best friend in doing early damage if he wants that SMG to be effective as they walk down and push in. That's such important that he's already taken 40 HP off of Mixwell. They won't carelessly throw this round away. They know that they were planning for it this early buy. The AKs can't exactly run riot against them. Alu now is going to come out to support that SMG by watching down directly. No smoke. Front finds the first. Good reaction to the right. And just like that, Rush says, I think I'll go back toward my friend Stanislaw back at spawn.
Yeah, not really much I can do. Like I said, limited utility. You don't have the incendiary to push him off. Or it's not really worth wasting a smoke. Alu, you'd assume he'll be rotating. Like I said before, once you get that one kill, you want to be going towards inner, like
perfect
he is
timing.
Right now.
Perfect timing as well. That smoke's going to dissipate. Naps trying to push through it. Kyo's going to have information. They're already in. Where's the peek from Alu? He's got to go quickly. He's allowed his teammate to get flanked out as Naf slipped in behind. Good shot to follow up on Stan, but it does give Naffly such a forward stance he can hold off the rotations. A bit of a team flash comes through, but Bomb's not planted. Rush is holding this off because he's not sure where the rotations came in from CT, and as such, I don't think there's going to be a bomb plant. One versus four, already hot on top of him. This is the first shot, but they line up and give him two. He still doesn't know there's a third above. That could have been very interesting.
Yeah, it certainly could have been, but there it is. Ultimately, a comfortable round for FaZe. They know it's going to be an ego for Optic next round, so they're okay with that. It's not ideal for sure. The Rain's got $8,000, 5K for AZ as well. They can certainly buy into this. It's going to be an eco against him, so they can farm some money and go into this round. There it is. Alu, this is one of the reasons he is a top AWPer. He's got a really good understanding of the game and the impact he can have with one of those AWP picks at the start of the round. Towards Ivy, like you said, the secondary terrorist is going, nope, not going anywhere near that. He falls back, and at that point, Alu rotates the connector. He's at a perfect time to take down his Indie Execute coming in from Optic, and he manages to find the round. Here we go then, 10-8. It's going to be a full execution for Optic at this point. Not really investing too much. PD50, Tech-9s, no armor. There'll be four smokes used towards Outer by the looks of things, and the bomb right now heading towards Brown Halls. Maybe this is a similar tactic we saw from FaZe. You just smoke towards outside your presence there and try and find the one player who presumably by himself on the inside side of the rock.
And the nade coming through as well to follow up on that damage. Alu. Huge contribution early on. Kerrigan the next. Interestingly enough, they're leaving Rain toward that sandwich position. Keep in mind, I'll touch on that. Kerrigan played with a Strawless. Played it well based off his teammates. Good positional control from FaZe. They're within one.
Yeah.
And that was one of the things I was going to say, that when Kirby came into the team, replacing Cajun B. It was Cajun and Kerrigan that played very well between Sandwich and Alley together. Kirby and Kerrigan never found that same synergy. So interesting to see Kerrigan changing his own role and own attention in this map now that he's joined into the FaZe lineup.
Well, here we go then. Another gun round coming in, round number 20. FaZe kind of going to tie things up at 10-10. A much better showing than what we saw earlier here. Looking at the pie for Optic, we have got five AK-47s. We've got all the smokes required as well. This will be one of the first real gun rounds going forward. Get into this one now. More of a deep on the city. They have got some smokes going out. Players positioned towards the dumpster. This could be some sort of execution. You see four of them actually lining up their smokes right now. This shows you, and this will be some sort of set piece going in. We've got Rush holding towards inner as well, waiting for any sort of aggressive pushes from the CTs. But full commitment could be coming in straight away, going for that plant. It's going to be down to Alu. Can he find his first shot?
Massive wall of smokes. Rain's on top of the train itself. The saving grace in this is AZ. He's up above in control room. He'll see above the smoke. He's already found one lineup, but Tarek, a lovely shot in return, will take that potential down. They can go for the plant fast, but they've got to get there before the smokes are gone. And Mixwell, he can't help. He can't contribute. He's got to cover off toward hell itself. Stan manages to get it down just in time. And he's actually got a good move on here because sliding up, they're not. Oh, take it back.
Yeah.
Alu is the only one that was in position to catch him. He could have rotated around Bomb Train and caught off both Rain and Kiyoshima. As such, they now have the man advantage, and Mixwell's going to try and play this out according to information where he can get it. Tarek's going to get a little bit with that quick peek. Knows they're both above, but can't land the second shot. It's all on the Tarek bomb. Got to know that it's planted above. They can't find it in the smoke. That won't matter. Rain's hit the shot. Plenty of time for the defuse. 10-10. FaZe fighting back impressively in this game. I didn't think this was going to be that close.
Well, there it is. So you can see Tarek, what he wanted to do there, get towards E-Box. If he could just slip to that position, he knows the bomb's planted on the train there. So he could have actually been a nuisance. He had low HP, is probably the last sort of attempt he could have had in that situation. Alu didn't do too much at the start of the round there, but stayed alive long enough to have impact towards the end.
Massive kill for him to get. Stanislaw gets behind that bomb train, and it's two down.
There we are. 10-10. Things have been tied up, but at this point, I do think we have maximum loss bonus. We do indeed. So, five rounds in a row, means you get $3,400 going into round number 21 here. With the bomb going down as well, you do get five AK-47s. Certainly not the best of buys, but it's more than enough to work with here. So it was a full execution last round. We haven't seen too much in terms of the detail from Optic so far. That's been one of the criticisms that I've given them, at least. They focus very heavily on the set pieces and the strategies. They try and force out on their opponents on the T side. And we'll see whether they can just adjust and work those picks out. And what's the next move here going forward? It seems like it's more of a default going here. You can see the 2-1-2 set up in the top left right now. It's trying to get some control of the inner horse. The idea, push the CDs back, take their vision away from them. So at least they have to expend some of the utility and force some rotations here. And work out what Optic are presenting to them.
Kyo's going to relocate. Doesn't need to play as aggressively to cover off the bomb itself because he's got Alu there on the AWP. Last blown out. Smoke towards Sandwich. Three players stacking that very aggressively. Kerrigan being one of them this time around. So heavy support and no presence at Ivy. But oh, Sandwich. necessarily the fastest rotation either. Taps with the AK is going to serve notice to Kiyoshima to get the Molotov out early so as they can't push through immediately and take advantage. He's got to try and position himself. Covers it off, but a flash comes through. He's pushed back already, and Alu, he's next in line to find this position, but it's to the left that he plays, and Tarek's already found Kiyo on the right. Bomb's going to be planted default quite quickly, and Alu's trying desperately to scamper into a new position to find a different opportunity, something to catch a pickoff as the retake does come in. Rotation's fast, but a good forward stance coming out from Optic. Takes down one already as Rainfall rush. He'll stay alive in this, and Nav's just buying so much time, he may not even come into the play. Alu last alive. They've got money to work with. Good start to the half. It's one round in hand. He's got an AWP. He'll be able to buy another, but he loses it this time around.
A few small mistakes there made by FaZe Clan. You can see Kiyoshima. If ever there was a time to say one and done position, that would be it. Like he found himself rotating, heard them coming in, had to commit, standing in the open, doesn't find one kill there. The CD's rotating as well, tried to deny the bomb with incendiary going on the site. It wasn't deep enough to actually stop the plan going down. So just a few key mistakes there in the build up to that round. And you see Tarek, that's the position I'm talking about. Kiyoshima, that's a nightmare to be in. You've got nowhere to fall back to. Just standing in the open, just have to take the duel. Tarek takes him down, and at that point, you know as a team you're going to win that round. When you get that first kill, with nothing coming back quickly, and it will be Optic finally arriving here in the second half. 11-10, and they do take the lead once more. This is interesting though, Matt. We've got the Kiyoshima auto sniper, but before I can even finish that sentence, Alu has gone down. That's a secondary sniper, the orb going down at the very beginning of this round.
Picked by Mixwell. No less as Rain stays elevated on the train. Rush won't back away so easily this time. He's got an AK. Kerrigan.
Okay, so you can see, I assume Ali went for that aggressive pick towards Ivy, and they were expecting it. Took him down. That's Mixwell's position. That's how he got that kill right now.
Kerrigan's grabbed the AWP off this, though. So he's left the M4. They want the AWP back in the play, so he's used it at various times in TSM / Astralis. Go back to it here. Smoke out already inside Sandwich. Loose one of the boxes. It's a very scattered wall to try and get front sight control, but they aren't going to utilize that. Right now they want to try and force the defense out of position. Now Tarek will start to slip in. You get an angle and a crossfire set with Naplight will walk out with Pop Dog. Rain's the closest to them. If I'm not mistaken, he's bisped it on Ticket Booth, which is a perfect position to be in. Lines them up already. Two in front of them, only finds one. Stan gets the response. That'll allow the bomb plant to come in, and problems all around because Kerrigan can't land the op shots. Rush walks in, takes him down, and FaZe, their run of success may be halted because suddenly, yeah, with two rounds against them, there's very little money left in their camp.
It was actually a nice idea from FaZe there, but Alu, who's going for that aggressive pick towards Ivy, a lot of top wards will do that at the start of the round, is try and lock anything down. We did say Optic are a set-piece-based team normally on the T side here, so that's actually a pretty intelligent decision to make, but Mixwell is waiting there in T-spawn for the aggression to come in, takes him down, and the round falls apart there. The best opportunity FaZe had was Rain in that connected position, had two on his screen. Spray didn't really go in his favor. He gets one, but taken down straight away. Two players survive. FaZe Clan has to be Kiyoshima on the auto sniper.
Thank God. We get to see it again next round.
It's your favorite.
Not quite.
You've always said it. There we go then.
I don't use the scope on it though.
No, just no scopes all around?
Yeah. 360s.
Yeah, well, with these teams playing, that's pretty appropriate.
That was the shot on the replay that actually could have changed it tremendously. If Rain picks up both those, bomb doesn't get planted.
You would normally expect a player of his caliber to be able to take those down. Like, he's very, very good, actually, in contention at one point for being one of the best players in the world. And
remember for a while, he was going to Fnatic, in fact.
Yeah. Well, then, so we do save two weapons here. The FaZe can't really justify the force around it. Get some PD-50s. I'm hoping this auto sniper has some big impact here. Kiyoshima decides to take it towards Heaven. A good place to take it, I would say. Obviously, if the smokes come in, you can just spam through them and probably deny him the plant. Potentially, here's his chance to shine. This is the first one that gets the second.
Picks it up right after AZ gets nap as well. So this is all dead even. In fact, it's just getting pulled back as Tarek finds one. Good pickup from Rain. Still has control of the train, but he's the only one left. Knows there's one at E-Box. Tag down, 32 HP, no armor. Aim punch is a massive factor for him in this. So too is that Molotov and, well, an 8. Yes,
everything.
Knew exactly where he was.
Yeah, it didn't really go too well for him. Did everything he could. He picks up the M4. It all came down to Kiyoshima. Had he lands two kills at the start of the round, maybe it could have been a different story. The M4 could have had a bit more impact there, but unfortunately, just gets one, and then Tori gets his head ripped off there. But you can see why they took a little bit of an eco here. FaZe wanted to concentrate on this round going forward. Certainly not the best fight. They get 5 M4s here. No head armor. Not a huge deal at all against these AKs and the AWP. We could go to round number 24 here. Optic looking to close things out. There will be four smokes for FaZe kind of here. One incendiary on one kit. He assumed it will be the one fighting this. Look out for him. Tarek, open things up. Clear reply by Rain, though.
Tarek. Nice shot, Napfly, better and still as he takes down Alu. Around the E-Box, he's found out where Kerrigan's playing, he's got him as well. Another 3K from Napfly. And that's going to mean just Kiyoshima remaining in a situation that goes from bad to worse. because suddenly, despite getting guns up this time, three rounds is now going to be four against him, so a little bit of a money bonus. They're on $200 on Kiyoshima, who stays alive right now. 400 best case for Rain. And they're going to find themselves with 14 rounds accumulated. Important that Kyo saves this gun.
Yeah, absolutely. Can we just have a look at the money quickly? So they're going to have a four-state loss bonus after this one. So $2,900, saving the M4 is just a must at this one. They won't have any chance. I think they'll have to eco regardless, but we'll see what happens. To be fair, we 14-10. It decided to have guns going down a bit. They want to force buy and potentially call the GG at that point. It's a real difficult decision going into the next round. Four phase, obviously run away with this one. It's going to be two players surviving, but they've got so much money available. You can see Rush, 10K, Tarek, 6K. They've got money for days. They can close this one out if they want to. So he does save the AK-47. A pause comes in. I'm going to assume this is tactical for FaZe Clan. Of course, it will be. So they saved an AK, and they have about 3K average. We do have
the new rule.
It is a new rule. We weren't 100% sure about
so
that.
This is, yeah, the second one called from phase.
That's kind of cool. Never seen that before. The two remaining thing.
Way to go, ECS. You're smart.
We've actually made it. That was a real struggle for us in previous tournaments. Working out.
It was a struggle for everyone. Yeah, including the players at times, especially in Brazil.
Well, there it is. So, like I said, there's two options here. Choose the lesser of two evils. And it looks like maybe a force buy coming in here. The freeze time comes in. It's an AK. Rain buys a scout. They're not forcing this necessarily. Rain's kept his money about 2K. After this one, there'll be a maximum loss bonus. I think get the AK out. They've got a scout to back it up as well. Some upgraded pistols. Try and see what they can do here. It's not going to be great, but if Kiyoshima can find some really incredible form of that AK.
Yeah. I mean, what else can you do? Round 14, you're going to force the next, as you said anyway. Buy what you can. You'll have a full buy. They win this. Great, exactly. They give themselves some time and space. More impressive game than I expected so far from FaZe, I have to say, even still. Especially to get momentum rolling in the second half again.
You have to remember, this is Optics, man. No one expected them, FaZe, to even touch this one after the last showing. So they're doing a good job so far.
Three players at Ivy this time. First time we've seen this face from Optic. Already a Molotov to clean out the corner. It's Kerrigan that wants to try and get a shot against them. But again, just a 5-7. He's got armor. He's one of the two with armor. So let's say there was one at Ivy. He gets a kill and gets a gun. There's a chance, but with three players there.
Yeah.
Highly likely gets traded before that opportunity presents itself. More passive approach instead from him as he'll fall back all the way around to back halls.
Well, you can
Kiyoshima
see
in mind.
The bombsite B is completely open right now. They're taking a huge gamble here. Five players outside. Kiyoshima needs to step up there.
Kyo's got to step up, but Kerrigan's distracting. He's on the wrong side of the smoke. No one's giving him attention. At the same time, Kyo knows he can't turn. Kerrigan's find one, but AK gone. Kerrigan's kill is still significant, though, because AC's got space to work on. Deagle can't close it out. Nearly pulls the aggro long enough, though, to get Kerrigan back into the mix. Let's not rule out Alu, mind you, because he's got bomb down. He's got a little bit of room to work with in behind the train, but again, no rifle, no armor for him to work with, and a Molotov that's going to push him. Now, that's not quite going to reach, so I say push him. They're still going to watch the lanes. He's trying to peek where he can, bait them into whatever shots he can find. Smartly crosses back over to the E-box, but still, they're just waiting for him to present himself, and now with both peeking at the same time, it gets even harder for him to find position against them. Trying to find shots up close, down he goes. Map point for Optic. But money there for FaZe, so we're not done yet.
So they were going for overtime here. We speculated about it before. This was the call. Try and get five rounds in a row. It's certainly not an impossible task on the CD side of train, but what we've seen so far, they had a great start here. They have lost five in a row now. They do get the double orb set up, sometimes a bit desperate, but it can be one of the strongest setups you can bring on the CD side. So what's the play here? Kerrigan orb. Alu, of course, he'll be joining in as well. Kerrigan, very slow game for him so far. 6-20 after 25 rounds. It's pretty shocking numbers there to go into the end of this game, but let's see if he can pull things together here. He's going to round number 26.
Thoughtful start to the round, of course. Kiyoshima is going to be the only one in the inner sight. Solo with an M4. And Mixwell started it off. Shot onto Kerrigan. Alu's going to try and redress the fact out toward Ivy, but no one's going to be moving. And Tarek's got position. Kyo's going to try and go up. We saw this position from the op in the first half. Spots the shoulder of Kiyoshima, so he's got a little bit of information. There is someone there, but Kiyoshima gets pushed back. So now not only down a man, they don't necessarily get map control back in the form that they were hoping to get. Leaves him inside of the B site alone. A minute still on the clock for Optic to work with this advantage as well, which is pretty massive.
Yeah, when you've got this much time to play with as well. Double orbs, going to be in the hands of Rain this time. Kerrigan couldn't get anything going there. 5-4, we still have three smokes available here for Optic. Full execution, like we said, that's a kind of tendency they have is those full set pieces. They can still do those, and they have the AWP in the hands of Mixwell as well. Just waiting for any sort of reaction coming from the CDs at this point. You can see them actually holding quite passively, not going to do anything about the situation now, hoping these double AWPs can deliver for them.
Pop dog, they go. Rapid 3-2 split in front of the site. Smokes off in the key choke points. One at the back of the train, though, is covered off. And now it's a shot, but he's wrapped around. Mixwell and Rush. The follow-up kills, and as I said, AZ smoke dissolves, but his vision doesn't matter. Tarek's got the headshot. It's down to just Kiyoshima rotating back in from the B side of the site. And this may be done. Optic, map one. 16-3 last time between them. He said it might be 16-10 this time. Mixwell closes it. Optic, after fighting back from the bottom of the bracket, they take map one in the decider of this group.
Great play from them. Like we said, we expected them to pick up train here. We move on to the nuke next, but overall, FaZe Clan, better show than we saw last time, which we kept mentioning. 16-3 last time these guys played. They got going on in the first half. They lose the pistol in the second round. They get bomb plants down. They got four rounds in a row. They managed to kick up four. Then as soon as the double orb set came up for Optic, they really got rolling there. They took the rest of the game pretty much hands down. And then we went to the second half. FaZe with the pistol again. They managed to get an early lead, but as soon as the gun rounds came in, fell apart once again.
Yeah, and to be fair, I mean, Kerrigan was quite slow in terms of his distribution in this game. Only 6 kills overall, and there is one that stands out. And I was around, they were playing for overtime. It was 14-10 at the time, so the 29th round. Mm-hmm. Rush pulls the aggro. He pushes through the smoke. If he hits that pistol shot, it goes to a 2-on-1 in their favor with bomb down over toward where Alu was playing. That could have swayed everything and give them a bit more room. So it's hard to highlight one play over the course of a game, but that was a shot that should have been hit. I would say in a month of Sundays, it should have been hit on all of them.
I just like the adaption overall from Optic. You can see they had a really solid game plan on the CD side. The orbs were aggressive. They were changing things up. They kept phase guessing every single round as to what was going on, finding those opening picks, rotating over. Like I said, I'm not going to pick out any particular play. I just love the actual rotation, the understanding of the CD Alpha train. That's impressed me the most.
Well, with that said, break time when we come back. We do swap it over. It is going to be a whole different task when we switch to Nuke and FaZe. Yep. Trying to go against Optic on that, it's a bit of an interesting one. Again, from now on, this map pool changes from what we would have expected. So anything could still happen, guys. We'll be right back.